Top of the morning to you. Tim Babcock here again with another broadcast from Fred Waring's America at Penn State. This month, we focus on Fred Waring's Irish music taken from portions of his television shows on CBS. Fred Waring was born and raised in Tyrone, Pennsylvania, a town named after the county in Northern Ireland. So it should come as no surprise that Fred's music library includes so many Irish tunes and melodies. What quickly became apparent to me in my research for this podcast was the difficulty in finding, in our vast collection, songs appropriate to this theme without searching our databases for individual titles. This difficulty makes the work of describing and keyword tagging the television shows so important. One of our current projects is doing just that, so that future research for a particular theme or topic will be much faster and capture all the possible songs and performances relevant to that theme in one simple search. Similarly, many of our radio shows still exist in obsolete formats, so our work in digitizing these formats is equally important. It's exciting work making usable and accessible this vast catalog of music, and we are making great progress. Okay, back to the music. As I mentioned, this month features the music of Ireland, and in some instances, the music and experiences of Irish immigrants in America. Fred's Pennsylvanians featured many great voices, but two voices in particular were especially appropriate for capturing the spirit and the tone of Irish music. When Fred needed a voice for Ireland's music, he often turned to Gordon Goodman and Stuart Churchill. Both of these fine singers uniquely fit the grace and elegance of Irish music and turn in some remarkable performances. I hope you enjoy these performances as I did, and listen and watch this podcast as part of your St. Patrick's Day celebrations. Please spread the word about the Waring Archives at Penn State, and feel free to contact us about this podcast or any of Fred's music. Aaron Gabra.
From machines that power America's progress to everyday conveniences for your home, you can put your confidence in General Electric. Fred Waring and the Pennsylvanians for General Electric. A full hour of musical enjoyment representing one of America's great industrial families and planned for your pleasure by Fred Waring.
Hello, everybody, and it's thankful we are for your warm welcome. If there's a peculiar quaintness to our tongues tonight, you will know that this long week through, we've worked to the bold music of St. Patty and the gentle songs of the little people. Even our fine sponsor, General Electric, will charm your cottage with the new and wonderful ways to hear music of the forest, to light your path brighter than the wick lamp, and to cool the butter cooler than the brook. Yes, it's Irish will be this hour, and already the boys and girls are greeting one another with the top of the morning to ye.
When we're turning in the air, that means the spring. The birds are than 100,000 workers or less. In your heart you feel a change work.
That means a thing.
And if you meet a calling,
here's what you say.
Break it up. And a cade mille falce to you, too. Would you be after joining us in a visit to St. Patrick's Day Parade? You'll find all the Pennsylvanians have become Irishmen for the old sort, even the Hennigs and the Tarinis and the Cronodonts. Well, if you're ready, then pin on your shamrock and let's go.
The Hallahans and Callahans who came from County Clare.
There'll be folks from dear old Dublin all the way to County Park.
They'll be marching in the big parade right here in Orchard
Yard. All the men will be in the big parade, right in Ireland. And behind him will march the thousand tops who came from Ireland.
The beautiful songs of air and all the bands will play them all.
I haven't seen Officer O'Goodman this morning. Wonder if he might have overslept. Suppose we knock on his door.
Michael Patrick O'Goodman, get off the flat of your back and on the beat.
All right. I'm coming, I'm dressed. Loud flannel mouth, old biddy.
Sure, I've roamed this wide world over, and of all the lands I've seen, there's no place I'd rather live in than my little Isle of Green. Only last night I was gazing on a sight that thrilled me through, but what I saw see no more. 'Twas too good to be true. Sure, the shamrocks were growing on Broadway. Every girl was an Irish collie, and the town of New York was the county of Cork. All the buildings were painted green. Sure, the Hudson looked just like the shadow. Oh, how good and how real it did seem. I could hear mother singing, sweet Shandon bells ringing. 'Twas only an Irishman's dream.
The policemen were swinging shillelaghs, and the bloody stone stood in Times Square. In old Central Park, what a glorious lark, they were singing, come on, yes,
sure, the Hudson looked just like the Shannon. Oh, how good and how real it did seem. I could hear
yesterday I sailed from out of port. I wandered on old errands and I landed in New York. There wasn't a soul to meet me here, a stranger on your shore. But an Irish luck was with me here, and riches came galore. Someday I'm going back again to dear old errands Isle. Me friends will meet me on the pier and greet me with a smile. Their faces sure I've almost forgot, I've been so long away. But me mother will introduce them all, and this to me will say, shake hands with your Uncle Mike, me boy, and here's your sister Kate. And there's the girl you used to swim by the garden gate. Shake hands with one of the neighbors and kiss the collie dog. You're as welcome as the flowers in May that bloomed in Donegal.
Yes, sure.
Meet Madigan, Hannigan, Anahan, Flanahan, Fagan, O'Hagan, O'Houlihan, Flynn, Shanahan, Manahan, Hogarty, Fogarty, Kelly, O'Keely, McGillis, McGinn, Brannigan, Flanagan, Milligan, Gilligan, Duffy, McCuffy, Malacca, Malone, Lafferty, Lafferty, Connolly, Connolly, Julie, O'Hurley, Malacca, Malone. You're as welcome as the flowers in May. Blooms in Donegal.
In a Dublin's fair city where the girls are so pretty, 'twas I first set my eyes on sweet Molly Malone. And she wheeled a wheelbarrow through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh. She was a fishmonger, and sure 'twas no wonder, for her mother and father were fishmongers before. And they wheeled a wheelbarrow through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels alive, alive, oh. Now she died of the fever, and no one could save her. And that was the end of sweet Molly Malone. Now her ghost wheels a barrow through streets broad and narrow,
saying, "I'll take you home again, Kathleen." Cousin Betty accompanies.
"I'll take you home again, Kathleen, across the ocean wild and wide, to where your heart has ever been, since first you were my bonny bride. The roses all have left your cheek. I've watched them fade and die away. Your voice is sad whene'er you and tears bedim your loving eyes. Oh, I will take you home, Kathleen, to where your heart will feel no pain, to where the fields are fresh and green. I'll take you home again, Kathleen."
Eyes are smiling, short is like a morning spring, and the lilt of Irish laughter you can hear the angels sing. When Irish hearts are happy, sure the world seems bright and gay. But when Irish eyes are
Stuart Churchill has found himself a sweetheart. Where? In a little garden where the praties grow. And that really means where the potatoes grow, in the old potato patch.
Have you ever been in love, my boys, or have you felt the pain? I'd sooner be in jail than being in love again. For the girl I loved was beautiful, I'd have you all to know. And I met her in the garden where the pretties grow. She was just the sort of creature, boys, that nature did intend to walk right through the world, me boys, without the Grecian bend. And did she wear a chic none, I'd have you all to know. And I met her in the garden where the pretties grow. Yes, I'm a pretty Catherine, I'm tired of single life. And if you've no objection, sure, I'll make you my sweet wife. She answered me right modestly and curtsied very low. Oh, you're welcome to the garden where the pretties grow. Yes, I'm a pretty Kathleen, I hope that you'll agree. She was not like your city girl to say you're making free. Says she, I like my parents and tomorrow I'll let you know. If you meet me in the garden where the pretties grow. The parents, they consented, and we blessed with children three. Two boys just like their mother, and the girl, the image of me. And now we're going to train them up the way they ought to go. For the day begin the garden where the pretties grow. She was just the sort of creature, boys, that nature did intend to walk right through the world, me boys, without the Grecian bend. And did she wear a chic none, I'd have you all to know. And I met her in the garden where the pretties grow.
The songs were created from the poetry of Aaron's famous man of letters, Thomas More, and carefully integrated by Roy Ringwald. It's called Erin Go Bragh, which means Ireland forever.
Oh, Erin's native shine.
some child of misfortune, I'll weep with thee tear for thee.
Oh, dark are our sorrows to pay, who will get them in spite, who are deep like the sun, giving showers. There never were hearts if our rulers would let them more born to be gentle and blessed than ours.
Blooming, I know, but
second, we have just about 15 seconds for an encore.
We have in a second to round the company made, the kind, the churl, the peck, and the muse, the way you wait. Past the pleasure that by parole, not off your strain, who keeps 3 hours from dying, which comes to life again. Quick, we have in a second to round the company made, the kind, the churl, the peck, and the muse, the way you wait.
Thank you very, very much. Solos for Doris Johnson on harp, Bob Harris, Jane Wilson, Hugh Fleming, Fred Campbell, Stuart Churchill, and Gordon Goodman. Ringwald's great Aaron Gabraw. Have a reminder of a wonderful treat for the children who will be watching our show next week. Not only for the children, but I want to tell them about it first. Next Sunday, we are proud to present for the first time the music from the coming Walt Disney picture, Alice in Wonderland. And that's not all. The little girl who does the speaking and singing for Alice in the picture will be our guest, and here's a picture of her. Isn't she cute? Her name is Kathy Beaumont. There's some photos and some cartoons here. Doesn't she look like Alice, though? Also, Sterling Holloway will be here. He's the Cheshire Cat. And Walt Disney himself will have something to say next week, too. So don't forget the premiere of the music from Alice in Wonderland on our next show next Sunday night. Meantime, please remember the crippled children. Care of your local post office. Send your contribution. Easter seals. Good night.
Fred Waring Show was directed by Bob Banner. This is Bill Bivens inviting you to join us next week when General Electric again presents the Fred Waring Show. This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.